City traffic is flowing. There are certain rules. Stop at red lights, go at green lights. There is a speed limit. Parking is not allowed everywhere. These rules have formulas. For example, the timing of the lights at the intersection. This is the formula. The number of lanes, green light duration, signal cycle time, these variables are set accordingly. And this is the safe following distance formula. Vehicle speed, road and tire resistance, and gravity are considered. That's how flow is ensured. We can call these traffic laws. So, in traffic, which matters more, the drivers or the laws? If drivers do not obey the rules, traffic becomes disrupted. Because rules and laws are not living. They have no will. They have no ability to act. Look, there are rules, but they are not enforced. What are the laws of nature in the universe? How do the laws work? After the Big Bang, time subatomic particles at zero point. Quarks, leptons, photons is being created. Soon their interaction, four fundamental forces are created. This is the first creation formula that organizes the universe. Extraordinarily complex, all the operations in the universe are formulated by law. There is not a single random thing. Invisible forces. The first is the electromagnetic force. This metal object attracts towards the magnet. I don't see anything. This is the name of the force that I cannot see, electromagnetic force. We don't see it, but it's there. I apply a force to this scale. Always set the same amount. I have to work for it. The electromagnetic force created is random, does not apply a shot. There is a constant and unchanging gravitational force. This adjustment is made by the formula itself. Can it do it? The second of the first four forces created gravitational force. Gravity. Isaac Newton discovers the formula. Newton's planets and celestial bodies, formulas describing movements. He also found it. Einstein spends years explaining the relationship between matter and energy, finds the formula of his relationship. Another genius, Erwin Schrödinger, discovered the atom position and energy of six particles. The famous Schrödinger about levels finds the equation. Paul Dirac is considered to be the most important physicist after Newton. He discovers the famous Dirac equation and wins the Nobel Prize. He writes the formula he found for electrons, but in the following years, every new discovery, to my amazement, the particle fits this equation. He sees and says,
"It seems to be one of the fundamental features of nature that fundamental physical laws are described in terms of a mathematical theory of great beauty and power, needing quite a high standard of mathematics for one to understand it. One could perhaps describe the situation by saying that God is a mathematician of a very high order, and he used very advanced mathematics in constructing the universe."
I fill this glass with water. The water does not exceed the limits of the glass. Without a mold, without a cup, if I pour this water, it will spill everywhere. There is no construction without formwork. Laws of creation, atoms and particles organizes with invisible ties, so quarks and protons and neutrons is being built. The whole universe, everything in the world, only one thing, namely with different combinations of quarks created. Objects, colors, smells, everything from one thing. Let us consider these grains of sand as protons and neutrons. A magical power touches subatomic particles and transforms them into protons and neutrons. The first bricks of the universe were like this thing. This is a model of the atom. There are neutrons and protons from the nucleus. Those floating around on the edge are electrons. But these electrons are not moving slowly, as you can see now. It travels at a speed of 2,200 kilometers per second. The speed of these electrons is the speed of an airplane, 9,000 times its speed. This little atom model has a battery. It's battery operated. However, it is not yet known at what energy electrons travel at a speed of 2,200 kilometers per second. Scientists have measured the speed of electrons and its position according to quantum mechanics trying to explain. As the number of protons and neutrons in the nucleus increases, element differs. The elements are so powerfully constructed by these laws that even after billions of years, this order and harmony remains unbroken. This is a printed book. There are spelling rules. There are printing rules. The font size is determined according to the size of the book. Sentences begin with capital letters. There is a letter space between words. There is a certain amount of space on the right, left, bottom, and top. There are many such rules. The mathematical formulas for these are as follows: content area formula, page ratio, row formula for number and spaces. These formulas can be easily used on the computer. I'm preparing a page. I easily format the page using formulas embedded in Word software, a paint program on the computer. There are colors, there is palette, there are eraser. But there are no writing fonts or book page layout formulas. No matter how hard I try, I can't stay organized here. I can't create a page because it's not a writing program, paint program. Rules and formulas have no will. All these spelling rules are made by humans, is produced and used. The Earth is a unique book with 1,000 pages. Everything is subject to the laws of nature, acts appropriately. Scientists are making observations, all kinds of rights, the equations of operation. One of the most important formulas of life, one is photosynthesis. This is the formula for the liveliness of information. Here are the scientists who discovered photosynthesis finds the equation. What about cells in living thing? How does it multiply? How do organisms grow? These scientists have the formula for, this is discovering, mathematical formula for cell growth. George Mendel discovers the laws of genetic inheritance. Organs of living beings from birth does not grow at the same rate. As they grow, their organs do not grow at the same rate. The baby's arm grows about 6 times. For example, eyes and arms are different grows at a rate. If the eye had grown at the same rate as the arm since infancy, an adult human eye would be the size of a tangerine. If we grew at the same rate, our brains would grow as large as our legs. Every organ grows as it was designed. Here is the formula, allometric equation. Julian Huxley discovers this formula. The temperature of this room is currently 25 degrees. The ideal temperature is 22 degrees. I need air conditioning to regulate this. I have to run it constantly. My body temperature is 36.5 degrees. Working on my body for life, there is an air conditioning system. This is called the law of homeostasis. The law of homeostasis was discovered by Claude Bernard and Walter Cannon. Every living thing has a body like this. There are mechanisms that keep that creature at the temperature necessary for it to survive. We can call this a thermostat or air conditioner. Think about it. There is nothing at first. Then the Big Bang happens. Everything is like this sea of sand, and these are changing. They take on different colors. And over millions of years, elements emerge. Then the first cell. Is the first cell simple? This is a simple robot. Let's say the smallest part of this robot is the screw I remove from here. Let the smallest part be this small screw. There's not much art to this screw, but there are technological innovations in the robot itself. It makes sound and moves. The art contained in this screw cannot be compared to the art contained in this robot. The art found in the smallest unit of living organisms, namely cells, is not simple. The first living cell, called the primitive cell, it's not even simple. Even that is a magnificent work of art. It grows, develops, multiplies. There is no question of anything happening haphazardly or by chance. The laws of nature, since the Big Bang, physics-chemistry formulas are perfect. It works somehow. As if a button had been pressed, living beings are appearing on Earth one by one. A bright and shiny light, the world is being created. If thousands of flawed creatures were to become a single flawless creature, we could say that it happened by chance or through mutation. There is not a single structurally defective plant or animal on Earth. Everything has always evolved towards perfection. There are no plant or animal fossils that appear to be defective. At no point in world history, in any era, do we find defective creatures. Every living thing is in accordance with its own structure, eyes, ears, nose, brain, heart, stomach, and intestines, created with hardware. All atoms, all molecules traffic standing or moving at traffic lights such as drivers. How can I explain this perfection? Either I must attribute consciousness and divinity to each of the 10 to the power of 80 atoms, or I must accept that all the atoms that make up the universe are in motion by the power and might of God. When people do not want to see their creator, when they want to deny him, they must first disregard order and harmony.
We assume that all planets move in an extremely regular manner. They don't. It's chaotic. Today, we assume that the deterministic rules we know, such as the laws of physics, work exceptionally well. No, it doesn't work. It's chaotic. So the whole universe is a mess.
But who arranges things of this size? There is something.
No, it is not regular either. Unorganized. Completely unregulated. Everything is chaotic. The whole, you look at the chaotic sky.
But there is order in chaos, huh?
No, there isn't.
When people refuse to accept their creator, it becomes comical. 50 years from now, the exact time of sunrise is certain, yet the universe is in chaos. Every spring, 1,001 flowers bloom, yet the world is in turmoil. All living beings are born, grow, and develop perfectly, yet everything is disorderly. If the universe and the world we live in are disorderly and chaotic, what can we call orderly and organized?